Okay, I don't know how to start this video off. I normally don't do videos like this. And before you ask, Jess, this is a story time. I'm going to be talking about what happened to me yesterday. But this is also a thank you letter, in a sense. Because this story time, my experience at Guitar Center is probably one of the best things to happen to me in recent memory. So I'm just going to tell the story, my whole day, from beginning to end, just to get you into the mindset of this. Before we start, if you go to the description of this video and the comment section of this video, both at the top, you'll see a link to Bryan Roper's YouTube channel. This man is a living legend, dude. I'm asking you all just to go over to his channel, subscribe to him, and just listen to his music. He has an album on there and on Spotify and a bunch of other applications. Okay, let's just get into the story. So I woke up pretty late in the day because I was just really tired. And I had to go with my mom to Walmart to do some errands. But it's also the day I was going to get my first ever guitar fixed. I'm going to fix my favorite guitar at the time. And basically we're just going through Walmart and I just enjoy spending time with my mom because she's always working. So that's what we were doing. Just best day ever. She finds this. So already my day is good. Like, this is just amazing. I love this. I'm going to wear this everywhere. It's the first couple hours of my day. Now we get here, right? We have to stop for a little bit before we go to Guitar Center. And mind you, this is not the only thing we're doing. After Guitar Center, we had to go take my brother to get his glasses. So we were probably going to be in a rush. When I got here, Grand Theft Auto, the definitive edition, arrived from Amazon, which is a game that I am going to play on the channel. Don't worry about that. Also, new episode from the Minecraft series coming, I don't know, not tomorrow. Definitely not tomorrow. We got to Guitar Center, and I was taken back. The amount of instruments that were in this establishment were incredible. The amount of guitar, like the Gibson Les Pauls, the Fenders, dude, it was something I had never seen before. I'm telling you, I had never seen something like this. First thing I do is I tell my mom, there's like a line at the repair shop for the guitars. And I'm like, oh man, I've never seen stuff like this before. Can you hold the place with the guitar? I want to go play the pianos, the basses, all that. So I just go around, I play a little bit of Bohemian Rhapsody on the piano, you know. A little bit of Imagine, John Lennon. And then I play bass for the first time ever. And Jesus, those strings are freaking thick, dude. It felt like I was just, oh my God. I'm done. Either way, we get to this checkout place for the guitar repair center or whatever. They tell me some springs are wrong, the action on my guitar is too high, and it's like $100 to fix it. I don't have $100 to just throw away like that, you know. We're not homeless, but we're not rich either, so we couldn't fix the guitar. So I just tell my mom, well, you know, we gotta go and all, but we have a little bit of time. Is it okay if I stay and play some instruments? And she says, okay, I'm going to go do some shopping somewhere else. And I can leave you here and you can play guitar. And I'm just playing everything. I'm playing the piano again. I played drums for the first time ever. Ever. Then I go to the acoustic section of Guitar Center. And there's this really kind old man. I didn't get his name. But he was playing a harmonica and playing guitar at the same time and singing. The dude is incredible. I play with him a little bit. We talk, you know, we talk about our favorite guitarists. He thinks I'm like a professional or something. He's like, oh, can you play a G for me? I'm like, I don't know what that is, brother. I can't help you with that. And then this dude walks into the store. And I'm like, okay, weird. And then I'm just strolling by the Les Pauls and my eye catches a teal Fender Jaguar 60s Vintera. I said Jaguar really weird there. It's Jaguar, I think. And I just start jamming on that. Now, my mom comes back by the time I play two notes on the thing. And she's like, okay, we gotta go. Mention you, the guy who walked in is still watching me. And I'm like, okay, but can we record some, like, can you record me playing it? This is the guitar of my dreams, man. And it is. It's the guitar of my, it's like the one that Kurt Cobain played He played a Sunburst one, but then the one he did make, the Jag Sting, the mix of the Jaguar and the Mustang, is the same, like, it's almost identical in the color, but I don't care, it's the best of both worlds, because I actually like the Jaguar more than the Jag Sting, but it still has the Jag Sting's, like, color, similarity, so, like, that's my favorite guitar ever. So I just start playing. She records some covers for me. I'm just there playing, like, Lithium. I'm on a plane, something in the way. And the whole time, this guy's just looking at me, right? And I'm like, I don't know the guy. So I'm like, is this dude, like, creepy or something? Like, I'm sorry. Like, the dude is super kind, okay? You'll see as the story. But I'm like, why is he just staring at me? And then eventually we film, like, 8 covers, which you'll see at the end of the video. And then I go put the guitar back. And I put it back. I'm looking at some straps for the guitar because I'm like, I want to get something from here to remember the day, you know, because this is like incredible. This is the best day ever. And as I'm walking back with the strap in my hand towards my mom, he stops me and wants to talk with me. And I'm like, I'm in a rush. I need to get my brother's glasses. So I'm like, not to brush him off. And I'm like trying to be friendly about it. Like, oh, I need to go or whatever. And he tells me, so how much is that guitar, right? About $1,000. Yeah, I'm gonna buy that for you. And now I'm just starstruck. I'm like, what? he said, yeah, let's go. I'm gonna go talk with your mom. And I'm just chasing after him. I'm like, what? He goes to talk to my mom. My mom is just flabbergasted. She's like, what? He says, go get it. I get it. I leave the strap. Who cares about the strap anymore? I'm like, what? This is too good to believe. Now I'm gonna admit something. Of course, I wouldn't say this there. The dude is super kind. But when he, like, told me that, I was low-key thinking he's going to pay for everything and then just dip and leave us with the bill or something. And it's not because I got bad vibes from him or anything. It's just because I'm, like, $1,000 guitar, like, this is too good to be true. This has never happened to me before. This is something, like, new to me completely. This is incredible. The dude is super kind. He does music, too. He used to work at Microsoft. And, dude, oh my god, I walk out of there with that guitar, and I feel like I just have to say this on the internet, like, thank you, man. This is the greatest gift I have ever had, besides my conception, besides me being born. This is the second greatest gift of my life. This is, oh, and that's on top of it, the guitar is enough. Then he asked for, like, a $400 case. I'm like, I don't even have a case. When I brought my guitar here, it was just stumbling in the back seat. He gets a $400 case, guys. It's leather. I have it right here with me. I'm going to play it. I'm going to do a cover with it in the end of this video. Bryan Roper, if you're watching this, thank you. Thank you. That's the end of the story time. We go home. We go back and get my brother's glasses. We're actually running a little bit late, but that who cares at this point? I am gonna go right now, get that guitar, take it out of the case, and show it to you guys. If you come from my TikTok, you'll see the photos I got. Here we go. Leather case. And by the way, Bryan, if you're watching this, I put my first sticker on it. It's the Ventura sticker. This is upside down. Guitar's just stumbling in there. The Ventura Jaguar sticker that came on the guitar. Either way, let's take this out of the case. I'm gonna play it. I'm gonna do a cover. You can already see the headstock. I'm gonna get this in frame. This thing is the most beautiful guitar I have ever seen. And I don't know if it's from the UK, Canada, or Mexico, because it says that on the back of the neck, like the headstock. I'm going to do a quick cover for you guys. I'm going to do I'm on a Plane and Something in the Way, because those are the last two songs I sang before I went and returned it. So yeah, I'm going to hook it up to the amp, and I'm just going to give a little demo, and then I'm going to end off the video. Once again, final time, thank you so much. Bryan, I promise you I'm gonna make an album with this, and I'm gonna be a man of my word on my second channel. I'm gonna go through the progress of me making my first album, and I'm gonna give myself a deadline of by the end of the year. I'm gonna try, and that's just for the vocals and guitar. I still have to get the bass into the bass and find a drummer, because As I said, I played drums for the first time, but I'm horrible at it. I can't be a jack of all trades in that aspect. So I'm going to try. You can track my progress on my second channel whenever I get done with the first, second song, whatever. And either way, regardless, I'm going to get to the cover now. This has literally been, it's been a blessing to get this from you, Bryan. This is just, it's literally my dream guitar. It's just, it's beautiful. Let's get to the cover. This is, I'm on a plane. No, I have some technical difficulties here. Okay, let me start.
Dripping from